Hello everyone, well today we are going to study about an interesting topic, that is milk. Well, milk is considered as the healthy food because it is a complete source of vitamins, minerals, fats and other nutrients which are essential for growth and development of the body. And milk is the first food given to infants. And you know, India is the largest producer of milk in the world, followed by the USA and China. Well, milk has got endless uses, but if anybody asks you what is the definition of milk, then how you will define it? Well, milk is a white, nutrient-rich liquid food produced in the mammary glands of mammals. It is the primary source of nutrition for infants before they are able to digest other types of food. Well, there are many health benefits of milk, which we'll discuss later in this chapter. If you watch the video carefully, I will cover all the information and knowledge regarding milk. So watch the video as I'm going to start with the chapter. Well, milk generally refers to milk from cows and buffalo, even though there are other types of milk like milk of camel, sheep, goats that are available in the market. But camel milk, it should be sold as camel milk. Only buffalo and cow milk, it should be sold as milk in the market. Now, we get milk from the animals, and animals are reared in the cattle farm. There are two types of animals. One is dairy animals and second category is of draught animals. The animals which give milk are called dairy animals, and the animals which does not give milk are called draught animals. So cow, buffalo, etc. are dairy animals from which we get milk. Now in the cattle farms, there are plenty of cows and buffalo, so it is impossible to milk them by using our hand. So generally the milking is done through the mechanical process. The machines are designed to apply a constant vacuum to the end of the teat to suck the milk out and convey it to a suitable container. Generally, in the houses, people use hand to milk the cows and buffalo. Now we'll discuss about the composition of milk. Milk has got around 87.3% of water, around 3.9% of fat, and around 8.8% of non-fat solids. Besides that, milk also contains vitamin B, vitamin C, vitamin D, and other minerals which are present inside the milk. Now we'll start about the processing of milk. Well, processing of milk starts with the receiving stage and then it ends with the distribution, finally when the milk reaches to the customer. During the processing of milk, there are two important stages. One is holding tank stage, where the milk is holded at 7 degrees for around 24 hours to 72 hours. And the next important stage is pasteurization, where the milk is pasteurized by using two steps that we'll study later in this chapter. Now let's describe me about the steps that are involved during the processing of milk. As I said earlier, one important step is holding. The milk can be holded at 7 degrees Celsius for around 24 hours and maximum of 72 hours. And then the milk is filtered and then pasteurized by using two methods, that is LTLT and HTST method. Then it is bottled and then finally it is distributed to the customer in the market. There are different brands that are available in the market, like Amul is the largest producer of milk in India. Which was founded by Varghese Kurien. Well, factories received milk from the dairies, and the dairy, the village or the local people, they supply milk, where the milk fat is checked by using lactometer, and then by using truck the milk is supplied to the various factories for further steps, for the further processing of the milk. In factories, the machine are weighed, and when the machine are weighing milk, that time the dirt or any other foreign particles are removed by using different types of strainer. And then after the milk is weighed, it is holded in the tank for around 24 hours to 72 hours at 7 degrees Celsius. Well, as I said, this is the crucial step. If the milk is handled or holded in the tank for longer period, then milk may get spoiled. Now after that, the milk is pasteurized by using these two methods, LTLT, long time low temperature, which is done at 62 degree for 10 minutes. Then high temperature short time, that is done at 72 degree for around 15 seconds. Now this is how the milk is bottled in factories. And after bottling, the milk bottle is closed tightly with the cap. And after that, the distribution of milk is done in special designed refrigerated vans to ensure that the quality of the milk is maintained. Milk is always stored at the raw temperature. If the milk is stored at high temperature, as milk contains vitamin C, the chances are high that milk may get spoiled. Now we are going to discuss about the nutrition value of the milk. As I said earlier, that milk is complete food. So milk contains around 4% of fat and around 4.7% of carbohydrate. Vitamin B, vitamin B2, vitamin C and D are also present in milk. And calcium is also present in milk. Beside that, iron, phosphorus, potassium are also present in the milk. Now, as I said earlier, that milk is a perishable item, so it must be stored correctly at the right temperature, because milks will get rapidly infected with the microorganism. And milk should always be stored at a temperature less than 2 degrees Celsius. The fermentation of the milk will start at 12 degrees and develops from 15 to 18 degrees. And at 22 degrees, the milk will turn sour. So it is always recommended to keep the milk away from the sunlight, as vitamin C and vitamin B2 content is destroyed. And the milk must always be kept away from the strong smelling foods in the refrigerator, as the milk may get odor smells from the other food items. Now we'll discuss about the different types of milk. One is dried milk. The dry milk should be stored in its original packaging as far as possible, and containers should be free from the moisture, and it should be sealed completely. Now there are different uses of milk. It can be served as a refreshing drink, either hot or cold. It can be served along with tea or coffee. Then it is used as a main ingredient for making sauce like bechamel. It is also added to rich to give richness and to provide smooth texture. And it is also used for making different types of cream, like single cream, double cream, whipped cream, etc. It is used for processing of various byproducts like butter, and it is a required ingredient for many desserts. Now there are different types of milk that are available in the market. Generally, milk is classified broadly under these three categories. One is fluid milk, then second one is concentrated milk, and the third one is cultured milk. Under fluid milk, we have different types of milk like whole milk, toned milk, then we have skimmed milk, we have pasteurized milk, then homogenized milk, then we have flavored milk, then we have fortified milk. Now we will discuss them one by one in detail. Now what is whole milk? Well, whole milk is fresh and raw milk that is obtained directly from the dairy, and the fat content is high because the fat is not removed from this milk. So whole milk contains the entire fat, as the fat is not removed like in other milk. Like in toned milk, the fat content is reduced to 2 because extra fat is removed, and it is used for making other byproducts like butter and cream. Vitamin A is also reduced when the milk is boiled and skimmed. Now skimmed milk also has got very less fat, and the fat content is reduced to around 0.5%. The vitamin A is also lost when the milk is skimmed, as vitamin A is lost in the presence of heat. Then we have pasteurized milk. As I said earlier, there are two methods of pasteurization. One is LTLT and other one is HTST. LTLT, long time, low temperature, and HTST, high temperature, short time. So these are the two methods by which the milk is pasteurized. Then we have another category, that is homogenized milk. Here the milk fat is broken into small granules, and the milk can be stored for longer period. The shelf life is enhanced when the milk is homogenized. Then we have flavored milk. In the flavored milk, we have different essence or various colors can also be added. It has got a number of other benefits, and it can be stored at room temperature without spoiling, because sugar is present in this milk and sugar act as a preservative. Besides that, we have another milk, that is flavored milk, as I am discussing. Well, you can see some pictures of milk. Now fortified milk. Well, this milk has addition of certain nutrients to improve the natural nutritional adequacies. The nutrients normally added to this milk are vitamin A and vitamin D, vitamin A and vitamin B. This milk is considered as good for health as it contains additional vitamins. Now there is another type of milk that is available, concentrated milk. The milk is reduced by boiling it. The extra moisture is evaporated and the milk become little thick. That is called concentrated milk. Then we have condensed milk. Condensed milk is sweet, and it is used for making many types of sweets also. Condensed milk, because sugar is present, then it can be stored for longer period of time. The shelf life of condensed milk is higher than the normal milk. this milk value, since it contains all the nutrient present in the milk. The amount of moisture should be approximately 27 degree. As I said earlier, the remaining moisture is evaporated while heating. Now, these are the some brands of condensed milk that are available in the market. Then now coming on to the next type of milk, that is evaporated milk. This is unsweetened condensed milk. The milk is first pasteurized and then it is sterilized at 115 for around 15 minutes. It is concentrated in steam heated vacuum pans at temperature between 50 to 55. The nutritional value is same that like a fresh milk. Then we have dry milk. In this type of milk, the 97% of moisture is removed. It is normally retains all the original nutrients. Well, dry milk can be stored for around 6 months. As the moisture is evaporated, the shelf life is increased. Now we have another category, that is cultured milk. Well, it is fermented milk. It has sour flavor and it retains all the nutrients of the original milk. It is more digestible and than fresh milk. It contains some healthy friendly bacteria like lactobacillus. Then we have butter culture and yogurt cultures. Well, butter and yogurt cultures has contained lactobacillus, as I said earlier, and these bacteria are present in our gut and they are 70% of our immune system. Thank you very much.